हेलो, वेलकम टू एवरीवन इन दिस वीडियो। दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर 24। ऑलरेडी 23 लेक्चर्स कवर्ड टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम, थर्मल फिजिक्स प्रॉब्लम आस्क्ड इन द बुक, दैट इज गार्बंसल घोष, अनदर वन इज द रॉय गुप्ता। सो इफ यू वांट्स टू वॉच द प्रीवियस लेक्चर, यू कैन गो टू द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स, लिंक आर गिवेन देयर, एंड देयर आर सेपरेट प्लेलिस्ट फॉर द थियोरिटिकल पार्ट ऑफ थर्मल फिजिक्स, यू कैन गो थ्रू द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स ऑल्सो। And there are various physics related different playlists are available in this this YouTube channel. You can go through the description box, link are given there. In this video, I want to discuss that is problem number 1 to 7 of chapter 7 of this book is consists the entropy chapter, right? So in this chapter, we want to just discuss the 7 problem asked in this book. So let's start with problem number 1, which says that calculate the increase in entropy of 1 kg of ice when it melt at 0 degree centigrade. That means there is a ice, 0 degree centigrade ice converted into 0 degree centigrade water, right? 0 degree centigrade water, just is change is state. There is no change in temperature, just is change is state. So you know, for that the heat will be change will be Q equals to ml, mass into latent heat. So the entropy change equals to, you know, the change of energy, change of heat by temperature. So the change of heat is m into l and temperature T. Here the m is given here 1 kg, 1 kg, and l is the latent heat, which is given like that, 3.36 10 to the power 5. And the temperature, you know, 0 degree centigrade is 273 Kelvin. So if you just calculate, you can get this answer 1230.8 joule per Kelvin is the entropy change of this transition of state. Go to the next question. Next question says, calculate the increase in entropy when 5 kg of water is heated from 20 degree centigrade to 80 degree centigrade. Here what happened? 20 degree centigrade water converted 20 degree centigrade water converted into 80 degree centigrade water, right? So there is no state change here. The increasing of temperature, whose heat will be mcdT, right? mcdT, mcd theta, or you can see mcdT. This will be the head change. So the entropy will be dQ by T, and dQ is mcdT and T. So if you integrating mc ln T2 by T1, just put this value. M is 5 kg, C is the specific heat, which is given here 4.2 10 to the power 3 joule per kg per Kelvin. Okay, and the T1 and T2, T1 is 20 degree centigrade converted into Kelvin, 293 Kelvin, and T2 is 80 degree centigrade, 353 Kelvin. So put this value, you can easily find out this answer. Go to the next one. Next question says, 10 gram of ice fully converted into steam at normal atmospheric pressure. That means here the ice, 0 degree centigrade ice, first convert into 0 degree centigrade water, then it convert, this is state change, so this is ml, take ml1, and this 0 degree centigrade water convert into 100 degree centigrade water, that is temperature change mcdT. And then again this water converted into steam, that is 100 degree centigrade steam, they are mn2. Okay, so there is 3, q1, q2, q3, there is 3 heat change, q1, q2, q3, right? So the temperature entropy change, delta q1 by t1, delta q2 by t2, this is state change, this is state change, and middle one is the increasing temperature, which is mc ln T2 by T1. This is used here. So just put this value. M is 10 gram. L1 is the 80 calorie per gram for the fission. And L2 is 540. Temperature is 273. T1 and T2 is like that. So mc, C is, you know, in CGS unit, the C of the water will be 1. Right, specific heat of water in CGS unit is 1. So put this value, you can easily find out this answer. Go to the next question. Next question says that prove the inequality of Clausius for refrigeration cycle. That means you need to prove the inequality of Clausius inequality in case of the refrigerator. You know, refrigerator take the heat from the sink and work done on the refrigerator eject heat to the source. And heat flow from low temperature to higher temperature with the work done on this refrigerator. Okay, you know that. So the Q1 equals to Q2 plus W, that is Q1 is greater than Q2. So the net heat change of this refrigerator is minus Q1 because it eject Q1 and take Q2. So minus Q1 plus Q2. Here the Q1 is greater than Q2, so this must be less than 0 because this part is greater from that one. Negative part is greater compared to positive part. So the overall this will be negative. Okay. So if you divide it by T, you know this will be equals to 0 because you know Q1 by T1 equal to Q2 by T2. If you taking this integration, so for reversible process this will be equals to 0. But in case of irreversible process, you know, in case of irreversible process, work done is greater than compared to reversible process. That means this work done for irreversible is greater compared to the reversible process. And you know the work is nothing but Q1 minus Q2. So this Q1 for irreversible minus Q2 greater than Q1 for reversible minus Q2. Here Q2 is same. Depending upon this W, the Q1 will be changed because the W is different. So Q1 will be changed. So from here, these two are cancelled out. So you can see for reversible, this Q1 is greater than compared to for irreversible is greater compared to reversible. From this relation delta Q by T, you can see delta Q1 by T1 and delta Q2 by T2. Since this will be the greater, negative parts will be greater. Since this is 0, but this become greater, negative part greater, so this must be greater less than 0. Right, when these two in reversible process these two are equal, this become 0, but this part will be greater in case of irreversible process, so this become less than 0. So that's why in case of irreversible process this is less than 0. So finally, in the combination of reversible and irreversible process, you can say this is the delta Q by T less than equal to 0, which is Clausius inequality. So in case of reversible this must be equal to 0, in case of irreversible this is less than 0. So in general you can write this one. Go to the next question. Next question says, using inequality of Clausius, using this inequality of Clausius, so the efficiency of heat engine limited by this. So the efficiency of any heat engine are like that. So Clausius inequality says that, and you know for in engine Q1 is taken from source and Q2 ejected to sink. So Q1 by T1 minus Q2 by T2, because this is in and this is out, that's why this is minus. This is less than 0. So from here you will be get this one. So T2 by T1 is less than equal to Q2 by Q1. You know the efficiency W by Q1. So W equal to Q1 minus Q2. W equals to Q1 minus Q2 by Q1. So this is 1 minus Q2 by Q1. And you can see here this Q2 by Q1 is greater than that one. So this is greater than that one, but if this reduced, negative part reduced, so overall will be increased, that's why this is greater than. Clear? Q2 by Q1, when we replace by T2 by T1, this part is lower compared to that one, this is lower, and negative part lower means this become greater, that's why compared to this one, this will be greater. You can write down here also, from here you can prove that is minus T2 by T1, you know, is greater than equal to minus Q2 by Q1, because minus will change the less than. And if you take 1 in both side, you can easily says that is Q2 by Q1, and this is nothing but eta, this is nothing but eta. So 1 minus T2 by T1 is greater than equals to eta. So finally you can see this eta is less than equals to T1 minus T2 by T1. T1 minus T2 by T1. So in this process you can also prove that. Clear? I think clear. Go to the next one. Next question says that consider a system of temperature TS. This is a system whose temperature is TS. Thermal contact with an heat bath of TH. This contact with this heat bath TH, where T is greater than T1. If the heat capacity of the system remain constant, over the this interval. So the temperature equalization, since this are temperature gradient, so temperature will be equalized. Since this temperature is higher compared to that one, so heat flow from the higher temperature to lower temperature. So there is heat intake, so the heat is inject. So this delta Q is positive. Since this delta Q is positive, so delta is also positive. So the entropy will be increase of this system. Okay, so in that case, when the system temperature is lower compared to surroundings, the heat flow from surroundings to system, so in compared to this system, heat flow within this system is positive. That's why the entropy of this system will be increased. Clear? Go to the next one. This question says 2 mole of gas occupy volume 10 liter at 4 atmospheric pressure. So 2 mole of gas whose volume is 10 liter, pressure 4 atmosphere. The gas is heated at a constant volume till the pressure 8 atmosphere. So volume is constant. This is isochoric process. So this is isochoric process. Pressure change into 8 atmospheric pressure. Pressure change into 8 atmospheric pressure. So in this process, you can see the volume is constant. So PdV, that is work done per day, will be 0. Only dQ equal to nCV dT. PdV part will be 0 because V is constant. Okay. So nCV dT. And just integrating, you will be get ln T2 by T1. And you can see here P is proportional to T. So T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1. And you put P2 by P1, you will be get ln 2. So nCV ln 2. In the next part, it is allowed to expand at constant pressure. Now this pressure is becoming 8 atmosphere. At this constant pressure, volume increased to 40 liter. Volume is still constant 10 liter, so it's become 40 liter. So this is isobaric process. This is pressure constant. So this is isobaric process, right? So this is isobaric process. For that, the heat change will be nCV dT and PdV, right? So if you change this volume into temperature part, RT2 by P1 and this one. So you will be get these things. And you know, if you take this common, n CV plus R equal to CP, or you can remain in CV plus R, no problem. And this is dT by T because dQ by T is entropy. So if you integrating, this is T2 by T1 and T becomes, T is proportional also V, so this is V2 by V1. And V2 is 40 and this is 10, so this is ln 4, right? So after obtaining this delta S1 and delta S2, total entropy change will be the addition of delta S1 and delta S2. Delta S1 is nCV ln 2 and delta S2 nCV plus R ln 4, right? So put this value, n is 2 mole, CV is 3, here they given CV 3 and R is 2. So if you put this value, nCV ln 2 nCV plus R ln 4, right? So if you putting this value, you can easily find out this answer. I think clear. If there is any doubt, you must comment in the comment box. This is all about me. And this is my contact detail. You can connect me with this Telegram channel. This is my online platform. And this is my YouTube channel details. Go to this channel. You will be get different physics related videos on mathematics. But like this session, if you learn something from this session, and share this video to your friends, either he or she also get benefit from this video. Subscribe this channel if you need this channel. Those already subscribed, thanks for subscription. Press the bell icon to get notification of upcoming videos. So take care. We'll meet in the next video as soon as possible. Thank you.